Bioluminescence, the phenomenon of a biological organism producing light, exists in many species of bacteria, fungi, and animals, and has fascinated humans for thousands of years. The variety of colors and patterns produced by bioluminescent organisms can create ethereal scenes, from glowing waves of jellyfish to caverns lit by brightly colored insects. In addition to marveling at the displays of color from bioluminescent organisms, humans have been able to implement bioluminescence for scientific and technological purposes, taking advantage of the benefits of biological light production. A wide range of organisms, including bacteria, fungi, and animals, are able to produce light by metabolic reactions within their bodies. This production of light is done for several reasons, and often an organism may use bioluminescence for more than one purpose. For example, anglerfish that live in the dark environments deep underwater produce bioluminescent signals at the lures that protrude from their bodies, which function to draw prey fish to the light, as well as to attract potential mates. Cookie-cutter sharks implement luminescent patterns that are thought to attract prey to darker spots rather than the lighter spots. Many oceanic fish use bioluminescence to communicate, such as almost all lanternfish, which have different spatial arrangements of photophores depending on the species. These arrangements of photophores give rise to different bioluminescence patterns, which help lanternfish distinguish each other, as well as coordinate swimming directions and depth within groups. Schools of fish often use bioluminescence to produce light that matches the intensity of sunlight from above, a technique referred to as counterillumination that allows them to evade predators. Many marine invertebrates also produce bioluminescence, although often for different purposes than fish. Corals found at shallow water depths often produce bioluminescence as a result of pigments that act as protection against intense sunlight. Corals in deeper waters produce bioluminescence to provide light for the symbiotic organisms found on the coral. In return for light, algae can provide the coral with oxygen required for growth. Various species of jellyfish are known to produce bioluminescence when attacked or hurt, a behavior believed to scare away some predators. Their bioluminescence can also serve to attract prey. The bright bioluminescent waves that illuminate beaches around the world are the result of certain dinoflagellates, which bioluminesce to attract larger predators that would repel predators that directly threaten dinoflagellates. In marine environments, especially in the deep sea, bioluminescence offers many benefits, and a great number of organisms possess the ability to produce light. While examples of bioluminescence on land are far less abundant than their marine counterparts, they're also some of the most well-known, such as the ever-familiar glow of fireflies or the mystical radiance of some mushrooms. Fireflies luminesce to communicate and attract mates, and many species can synchronize their luminescence to deceive larger animals. Other species of beetles have learned to mimic the light patterns of fireflies to attract firefly prey, which gives them food in addition to replenishing their supply of luminescent chemicals that they cannot synthesize on their own. The New Zealand glowworm, which lives in environments mostly devoid of predators, uses its characteristic luminescence to attract flying insects that become entangled in their strings. Certain species of fungi, particularly those found on decaying trees, use their bioluminescence to attract insects that can then transport spores to new locations, helping the spread of the fungi. Numerous species of bacteria use their bioluminescence in symbiotic relationships with organisms that are not able to produce their own light. Because it can often be difficult for bacteria to obtain their own food, symbiotic relationships, such as those found between bioluminescent bacteria and marine life, are a good method for both to obtain food by using the allure of the bacteria's luminescence. Alternatively, bioluminescent bacteria can become parasitic or lethal to their hosts, which often leads to its death. The glow from bacteria then attracts larger animals that feed on the original host and help the bacteria spread and multiply. Because of the wide variety of species in which bioluminescence is present, and its many uses by different species, it is clear that this phenomenon has evolved separately in different organisms over biological history. It is believed to have evolved at least 40 separate times. Because of the use of oxygen in the reaction that produces luminescence in almost all organisms, it is thought that bioluminescence evolved from a method of protecting organisms from chemical damage. In extreme environments, the combination of reactive oxygen species and exposure to sunlight would have placed significant stress on bacteria or algae to develop a molecule that could safely react with oxygen. When oxygen exposure decreased, such as when the atmospheric oxygen concentration decreased a few hundred million years ago, or when organisms began to move into deeper waters, the danger presented by reactive oxygen species decreased, and the oxygen-accepting molecule was repurposed. This theory coincides with the earliest known bioluminescent organisms, dated to be approximately 160 million years old. Many more complex organisms are believed to have evolved bioluminescence by uptaking bacteria capable of producing light, which usually offered more benefits than it did for bacteria alone. The hundreds of existing species of bioluminescent fish that implement light for luring in prey, deterring predators, and communicating with each other independently evolved bioluminescence at least 27 times, of which the majority involved uptake of bacteria, as indicated by the constantly growing number of fish that are found to have luminescent bacteria growing on their bodies. Bioluminescence is also known to have evolved separately from bacteria, as is the case for fireflies. Luminescence in fireflies is a subject of debate, as several compounds chemically similar to those responsible for luminescence are known to give fireflies a scent that discourages predators, but genetic evidence points to bioluminescence evolving from genes responsible for fatty acid metabolism. The origins of bioluminescence are unclear in many organisms. What is clear, however, is that bioluminescence evolved separately many times and now serves functions much different to those it served long ago. Humans have known about the bioluminescent properties of many fungi and animals for more than 2,000 years and have taken advantage of this phenomenon, from the ancient natives of Central America, who used glowing fungi for navigation in dense jungles, to the English miners who used fireflies to illuminate coal mines. Accounts from explorers detailed how ocean shores in the Caribbean were lit by flames dancing on the waves. Many well-known scientists, including Robert Boyle and Charles Darwin, were intrigued by bioluminescence and made attempts at discovering its cause, although their attempts fell short. In addition to using bioluminescence from animals, people aimed to understand how the light came to be in order to better implement it. In the late 1800s, the French scientist Raphael Horace Dubois researched beetles and mollusks, hoping to find the mechanism responsible for bioluminescence. Dubois discovered a substance that was oxidized by an enzyme in beetles to generate light, which he named luciferin after the Latin term for light bringer. Dubois also sent specimens to Edmund Harvey, an American scientist who was, likewise, interested in bioluminescence. Harvey discovered, much to his dismay, that the bioluminescent compound and the enzyme that acts on it was different between the species he studied, indicating different evolutionary pathways. However, this preliminary research determined the chemical nature of bioluminescence and encouraged more scientists to isolate luciferin and other compounds responsible for luminescence for further study. In the late 1950s, the Japanese scientist Osamu Shimomura purified luciferin while working with sea fireflies. These crustaceans had been used by the Japanese Navy to read maps in low light, and produced their own luciferin and luciferase. Shimomura was able to isolate both the compound and enzyme that acts on it, and over several years of work, demonstrated its structure. A professor at Princeton University recruited Shimomura to work with him on the bioluminescence of the crystal jelly, a jellyfish found in the waters off the coast of the western US. After countless hours of work, Shimomura disposed of jellyfish samples in a sink containing seawater. The jellyfish samples lit up, which Shimomura deduced was because of the presence of calcium in the water. He identified the protein responsible as the photoprotein now known as aquarin, and a prosthetic group now known as coelenterazine, which in the presence of calcium and oxygen undergoes oxidation catalyzed by the aquarin protein to produce light. Shimomura was also curious as to why the aquarin complex emitted blue light, but the jellyfish in the wild emitted green light. After further investigation, Shimomura found a protein, now known as green fluorescent protein, that turned high-energy blue light into slightly lower-energy green light. A Columbia University professor working with C. elegans nerve cells, Martin Cholfi, heard about Shimomura's discovery and, a few years later, used the protein as a tracer in living cells. A biochemist at the University of California, San Diego, Roger Tsien, altered the structure of green fluorescent protein to make proteins with varying emission spectra and intensities, making it possible to differentiate between differently marked proteins. Another Columbia professor linked green fluorescent protein to another protein without affecting the function of either, allowing for the use of green fluorescent protein in marking and tracing specific proteins. This development of green fluorescent protein earned three researchers, Shimomura, Cholfi, and Tsien, the 2008 Nobel Prize in Chemistry. Luciferin and green fluorescent protein are integral elements for many applications in the biological sciences today. Luciferin and luciferase are often used to quantify the efficacy of gene transfection studies. A gene of interest can be delivered alongside the gene for luciferase and be taken up by cells. If the cells express the uptaken genetic material, luciferase should be expressed as well. Adding luciferin, magnesium ions, and adenosine triphosphate will result in the oxidation of luciferin and a release of light. The typical luciferin for biological studies is firefly luciferin, which is easy to obtain and emits light at a wavelength of approximately 530 nanometers, corresponding to a greenish-yellow light. This method has been used to study gene delivery methods for various genetic diseases. Green fluorescent protein and its derivatives are often used in the biological sciences and are an even more popular choice for many applications, as these proteins do not require the addition of other substances for proper function. GFP can be used to quantitatively measure gene transfection in a similar manner to luciferase. However, unlike luciferase assays, no addition of chemicals is required following transfection. GFP can also be linked to other proteins, which allows for the tagging of certain proteins with fluorescent proteins as markers. These markers can reveal the location and movement of proteins, from which researchers can infer the function of the tagged proteins. The use of several fluorescent proteins of differing colors can allow for the tracking of many different proteins, which can give valuable information regarding the interactions of those proteins. Whole tissues, for example, neurons in the brain, have been successfully tagged with many fluorescent proteins at once to determine the interactions of proteins thought to play a role in diseases such as Alzheimer's. Green fluorescent protein has also been used in biosensors, such as sensors that cause a conformational change in GFP when the target molecule is bound. Because green fluorescent protein is biocompatible, it offers an advantage over synthetic fluorescent molecules, which can often be toxic. The study of bioluminescence has transformed human science and technology, both in research and in consumer goods. Genetic engineering of bioluminescence has resulted in novel bioluminescent organisms, such as plants that glow in the dark, which are quickly becoming entertaining products for children and adults alike. Naturally, Research into bioluminescence is ongoing and intense, with more bioluminescent organisms found every year, more genomes sequenced, and more uses for bioluminescence created. A phenomenon that has fascinated people for millennia, and for good reason, has become more than just one that we admire, but one that we use for our benefit and potentially for the benefit of the planet. Thank you for watching, and as always, if you enjoyed the video, leave a like or subscribe for more educational documentaries. Check out more videos on the channel or check out my friends' channels for more content.